Lowering Canada's carbon emissions is a huge and urgent challenge, especially in the oil and gas sector. The oil and gas industry wants to rely on carbon capture and storage, or CCS, as a primary way to lower their emissions. But will this work? In oil and gas production, CCS is supposed to capture carbon emissions before they're released into the atmosphere. That carbon is either buried deep underground or, as is often the case, used to extract more oil. The Canadian government has already committed over $9 billion for CCS. Alberta and Saskatchewan have added billions more. The results so far? There are now 7 CCS projects operating in Canada, mostly in the oil and gas sector. But together they capture a tiny amount of carbon, less than 1% of Canada's emissions. Now, oil and gas companies want billions more from government for this technology. But there are some serious problems to consider. CCS in oil and gas only targets emissions from production. That means it can only address, at best, around 15% of emissions from oil and gas, while doing nothing to the emissions from actually using the fuels. What's more, 70% of carbon captured from CCS in Canada is used to increase oil production and extend the life of oil wells by decades, adding new emissions. CCS is one of the most expensive ways to reduce emissions. It's been in development for 50 years, but still hasn't reduced in cost the way that proven renewable technologies have. CCS itself uses a lot of energy, causing more of the very emissions it's supposed to capture. Building CCS infrastructure will take too long, putting our 2030 emissions targets at risk. The main takeaway? In the short term, we need rapid and deep emission reductions in Canada's oil and gas sector. But CCS doesn't do this. It mostly serves to get more oil out of the ground. The good news is there are far more effective and cheaper ways to cut oil and gas emissions, like electrification, increasing energy efficiency, and reducing methane emissions. And the big picture? Lowering emissions in the oil and gas sector can help this decade, but ultimately, we need to stop burning fossil fuels.